Any great and prosperous civilization was built with a limitless supply of workforce. So civilization won't burn after all. It will flourish. Men, they will burn. I have waited until extreme left did what women currently are doing to men all over the world. And that is to abuse a law which was designed against abusement.
Betrayal of his oath of office, betrayal of our national security, and betrayal of the integrity of our elections. Therefore, today, I'm announcing the House of Representatives moving forward with an official impeachment inquiry.
Regardless of what you may think of his politics, the way President Donald Trump got impeached is the way women all over the world are destroying men, abusing domestic laws to remove him out of his home or remove him out of his office, only to destroy and to empower herself. You set up the entire world against him, you smear him, and then you hit hard. And these tactics can only occur in 2019, and only by this extreme leftist cult, which used to be a social movement, but has morphed into this abusive, angry, law-bending, fascist-like, modern feminist movement. They act like the modern woman, waiting for her opponent to do something which she can use against him. Report him, blow up the story, and convict him. If this can happen to the most powerful man of the world, imagine what they can and will do to you. Only this comparison makes me vote nay against any abuse of impeachment, as I vote nay against any law enabling women to report a man just because she can. I yield back to my video. I would like to show you a picture of six girls. Yes, this is me, Brittany, Nicole Pettibone, Lauren Southern, and Naomi. According to the Dutch newspaper The Volkskrant, roughly translated as the proletariat newspaper, we are the face of radical right. Of course, everyone who criticizes feminism or support men's rights is labeled radical right by the far left, who is always stupid enough to immediately reveal their true agenda. So I'd better show you a picture of four leftist girls instead. Yes, this is Lee, Ketri, Senna and Maria. You may think these girls are YouTube vloggers, a get-together of the makeup tutorial girls with the most views. It is in fact the new and all-female government of Finland. Lee is the Minister of Education. Ketri is Minister of Finance. Maria happens to be Interior Minister. And Senna is Prime Minister. And the rainbow child of two lesbians, which is bound to be fun for the Finns. Not that there's anything wrong with that.
No, of course not.
I mean, it's fine if that's who you are.
Absolutely. I mean,
while the new left taught you that judging a woman by her looks is sexist, their reporter Hassan Bahara, writing about political cleavage, ended up gazing at just cleavage instead. And according to reporter Marjan Abdulkarim, Finland is far from gender balanced. We do know the definition of gender equality by now. While this new Finland government seems quite gender balanced, modern feminists might not be quite satisfied yet. Only a mere 100% of this government are women. Those of you who have watched my video How to Destroy a Man will remember the draconian Spanish law against domestic violence legislated in 2004. This law is based on the notorious Duluth model, designed by feminist activists in 1981 to battle male privilege. They fashioned this law in such a way that the female was always the victim and the male was always the aggressor by default. More and more countries are now joining Spain in its zero tolerance policy on domestic violence. They searched for an infallible way which enables women to freely report and destroy men, and it's called coercive control. It's cleverly put down The new Scottish domestic abuse bill, of course, is also based on the Duluth model, meaning the perpetrator is always the man and the victim is always the woman. And even if the woman would have been violent, it would have been because of self-defense. In order to incarcerate a man based on absolutely nothing, they invented the so-called trigger event. And they even give examples of such a trigger event. How would you feel if you couldn't just decide to do the washing tomorrow rather than today without all hell breaking loose? The woman deciding to do the washing tomorrow is the first trigger event. All hell breaking loose is the man's coercive control reaction, which, according to the Scottish Domestic Abuse Bill, can and will lead to homicide, even without a history of physical abuse. Meaning, washing tomorrow will lead to homicide. The second trigger event would be the woman leaving the man. This trigger event will want to make the man kill his wife. But because the bill stated that coercive control can and will lead to homicide, you can now report a man at the slightest suspicion of a trigger event occurring somewhere in the future. So with the legislation of this bill, you can now report your man even before the trigger event even took place. No physical abuse, no bruises whatsoever, only because your husband was angry because you wanted to do the washing tomorrow. Those who are found guilty of these implorable behaviors face a maximum of 5 years imprisonment. Funny detail is that most examples of this coercive control is typically female, such as confiscating or destroying their partner's mobile phone, demanding that their partner eat certain foods, conducting regular inspections of their partner's home or body for evidence of infidelity. So it's easy to trace which of the genders put this coercive control bill together. After England and Wales outlawed coercive control in 2015, now Scotland and Ireland legislated the exact same law. Australia is about to legislate it, and all Western countries will follow. This is phanosyndry in action, meaning the ideology to eradicate all men. And all laws based on this feminist-created Duluth model is nothing short of a weapon of man destruction and designed to empower women and women only. Because these laws are cleverly presented to the public as being righteous, they still get legislated. In spite of 16 years of this Spanish Inquisition...
Nobody expects... Can you explain to us what happened yesterday at your home?
But a substantial number of cases have been based on trivial complaints, such as not letting the female partner watch a certain TV program, or not letting them finish a crossword, simply raising their voice, or even criticizing their partner's clothes.
Proving this feminist Duluth model law only leads to more violence. It's absolutely crucial for any man to be aware that these laws are constructed in such a way they destroy men and empower women, and at the same time enables the government to hunt down men. And they do it by just making every move you make punishable. And while hatred is being fueled between both sexes, all enables them to take away their children. And if a woman decides that she no longer wants to have your child, even after it's born, she can kill it in the near future, even if your son or daughter is 11 months old. You as a man, of course, will have no voice, as it is her body, her choice. Her homicide, your child. In June 2019, the Illinois Senate passed a bill called the Reproductive Health Act, which includes repealing the Partial Birth Abortion Ban Act in 2003.
Virginia's governor says he has no regrets on his comments earlier this week defending abortion, even as a baby is being born.
It's the biggest debate in the country over the last couple of days. But yesterday, Democrats claimed they hadn't heard Governor Northam's comments.
I'm sorry, I just don't know what he said yesterday.
Here's what Virginia's governor did say.
The infant would be delivered. The infant would be kept comfortable. The infant would be resuscitated if that's what the mother and the family desired. And then a discussion would ensue between the physicians and the mothers.
We're talking about a little baby girl who's been born and is on a table in a hospital or a medical facility. And then a decision or a debate would be had about whether or not you could kill that little baby.
Prior to today, you could not, except under exceptional circumstances, do an abortion after the viability of a child. Today, you can now do it for nearly any reason.
They have now been exposed in what they believe and the things they embrace and the legislation they would clearly advance if they had the opportunity.
Governor Pritzker signing the Reproductive Health Act, or RHA for short, into law.
When I discovered the hospital was not only involved in late-term abortions, but sometimes babies survived. Hmm. And if they survived, they were shelved to die in the soiled utility room. So one night a nursing coworker was taking a little abortion survivor, aborted at 21 weeks with Down syndrome, that's why he'd been aborted, to the soiled utility room to die, and I couldn't let him die alone, so I rocked him for the 45 minutes that he lived.
From Illinois, it will travel around the world, and we will have my country, the Netherlands, to thank for it. In 2004, the same year as the gender violence law in Spain was legislated, the Netherlands came up with their Groningen Protocol, which legalizes to kill a child up to 1 year in case of hopeless and unbearable suffering. With the consent of the parents to kill the child, medical consultation having taken place, and the killing is done carefully, whatever that means. 1 year. Under the social guise of compassion for the sick or women's health, this protocol will now be used as a model, just like the Duluth model of gender violence, to craft the new so-called Reproductive Health Act bill, and their true agenda is now clearly visible. First it was abortion. Then late-term abortion. Next point will be after-birth abortion. President Trump tweeted, "The Democrat position on abortion is now so extreme that they don't mind executing babies after birth."
At this week's State of the Union, President Trump addressed what some experts are predicting will be a key issue in 2020, abortion.
"I am asking Congress to pass legislation to prohibit the late-term abortion of children who can feel pain in the mother's womb."
Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay.
No.
The ayes have it.
Impeached in exactly the same way women destroy men, abusing the law. This president is holding civilization together and even keeps these women from giving birth to a child, except for the head, of which they suck out the brain and then crush, because the child was not viable. Not viable. Mind the ambiguous nature of their wording. Are you viable? Am I viable? I understand how they use the term viable nowadays. I'm not sure how they will use the term viable tomorrow. And no matter how you twist it, we are discussing legalizing homicides because of modern feminism. And just the fact we have to discuss this today is as mental deranged and sick as it is inhumane and unworthy of Western civilization or humanity as a whole. All will lead up to the legislation of the mother having the right to decide whether or not she wants to keep or kill her born baby. Because when it comes to phenocentry, it's all about having the power to destroy life. The danger of this law lies obviously in the feminist phenocentric mother who just gave birth to a baby boy. The gravest danger, however, is that they can and will twist their laws into something evil, such as prolonging the afterbirth time limit, which according to the Groningen Protocol is now up to 1 year. You know by now how these laws are constructed. This would empower the mother to legally kill the child regardless of the age. Then they changed the definition of the word viable. Viable means capable of surviving or living successfully. meaning you yourself can be deemed non-viable. If I haven't seen their methods of how they use the law to completely destroy men, I wouldn't even consider these kinds of doomsayings. This makes Aurelia Fira's exposure of the phonocentric agenda to castrate males a bedtime story. And it's not a coincidence that this woman is a member of a political party. Because to legislate such extreme laws, you need feminists in Congress.
My God!
Tuesday brought celebrations across the U.S. for the record-breaking number of women who made history with their victories. They ran and won in unprecedented numbers, adding over 30 seats in the House.
Closer, yeah.
But it's still a long way to go.
Well, sure, but more women are engaged as well. I mean, more women even for 2020 are in the mix at lower levels. I mean, I've gone to some of these campaign schools where they have record number of women signing up to learn how to become candidates.
It's a troubling sight to see these girls who appear to be university freshmen.
I'm Danielle Stella. And I am representing Minnesota in the 5th Congressional District against Ilhan Omar.
Grilling the old guard in Congress.
Yes or no, do you think that massacre was a fabulous achievement that happened under our watch?
That is a ridiculous question, and I'm
yes
not
or no?
No.
I will take that as a yes.
That was Omar. How great Al-Qaeda is. When she talked about the World Trade Center being knocked down, some people, you remember the famous some people, they can leave. And you know what? I'm sure that there'll be many people that won't miss them.
These female legislators are the gravest danger to men, as the most terrifying issue has to be their ideology. When Sanna became Finland's prime minister, the leader of the Finns party tweeted congratulations. He did this so with a box of popcorn, indicating he sits back and watched the downfall. Which brings me to MGTOW. Phonocentry created fourth wave feminism, and that irreversibly created MGTOW, which in its core I partly support. Just the mere fact that MGTOW exists points out there is something wrong with the women and laws in this society. Before studying MGTOW, I was under the assumption MGTOW would create the new founding fathers of our future society, but I learned that they don't even bother about society anymore. I think real MGTOW men do care, but that no red-blooded man can bear the sight of these Finnish rainbow family-raised feminists, social justice warrior girls governing a country, knowing this will happen everywhere. Unfortunately, here's where your sovereignty will end. While you may have given up hope on society, you are giving it away to these women. And so it be. But they will come and hunt you with their laws. There will be no such thing as a law against MGTOW. Lawmakers are shrewder than that. First, they will condense all groups such as MGTOW, MRAs, and the true radical misogynist social media groups into one manosphere and proclaim it a white supremacy, alt-right, misogynist bubble of Nazi-like fascists, which they have done. Then they can simply outlaw these movements, and they will use the same model as I mentioned earlier in this video. Let me create a doomsday scenario. For the greater good, women and men will be able to report men suspected to be part of this outlawed movement, and they will use the same McCarthyism-like campaign of spreading fear of MGTOW influence. The real red pill is the decades-spanning creation of a generation of women who are conditioned and groomed to become the new enemy.
As a woman, I'm asking, how many rapists must we kill until men stop raping us?
Simply substituting feminist for terrorist, which was the substitute for communist. While MGTOW is educating men to be men, it's the women whom ought to be educated to be women again. In that sense, both men and women are behaving exactly according to the agenda, which steers the feministic phonocentric agenda. Turning your back on women disarms women, individually and sexually. Turning your back on society arms women collectively and politically. Secondly, men seem to be under the assumption that men can just sit back and watch women founder on oil rigs, suffocate in coal mines, and being crushed under the bridges that they cannot build. Many men assume women will find themselves crying in a crumbling civilization because they don't have the men and real manpower to keep their matriarchy going. Of all men, MGTOW should know these women and what they're capable of. I assure you, women will have the manpower. This matriarchy will have an amazing workforce at their disposal. Their society will be built top-notch, because there won't be any women doing any muscle tearing on no oil rigs. No women in the coal mines. Not a female soul laying bricks in the streets. It might start to dawn on you whom their workforce will be. That's right. It will be you, the man. What else do you think this is all leading up to? The man-hating doctrine. The riddance of men's rights. The legislation of all these anti-male laws. The total empowerment of women, right up to the right to kill off their babies, and the future castration laws. What better workforce to build this new world than the castrated, obedient and submissive men? Any great and prosperous civilization was built with a limitless supply of workforce. So civilization won't burn after all. It will flourish. Men, they will burn. The handmaid tale, to whom many of you keep referring, might be played on the screens of your work camps. You know how they are. It is too late is a comment I frequently read under my videos. Hockey mess time is another one. I suggest it's too late for hockey mess time. Who do you think will be guarding this matriarchal building male workforce? It will be men. Once you have figured out finessandry, you know this manifests itself in laws which have already been legislated, where women have already got the power. You know what will happen when these women are given absolute power over men and children. As you know, men are obedient to these women and are legislating these laws for them. And to use the Matrix analogies one time, these are the real red-pilled men, because they are aware of these laws. But in the meantime, most people don't have the faintest idea what is going on out there. And although I understand the metaphor, blue pill means taking the easy way out, choosing to ignore the harsh reality and live in blissful ignorance. It's a good analogy, but might be worth to take a look at. Because to be able to choose to ignore, they have got to be offered the choice first. It's the events in my life which have led me to the choice between the harsh truth of reality or the calm illusion. Without concept of choice, one cannot be blamed for not being informed, let alone to take action against problems they are not aware of. Yet those being unaware are labeled as blue-pilled, while those who are aware, or red-pilled, are oftentimes refusing to take action. Creating a defenseless minority, this leaves raising awareness as the only option. And this cannot be done underground. It has to be done via mainstream media. This is when I have to address the growing radicalization within MGTOW. Sit back and watch society burn. Hockey mess time, kill modern women, hinting to a Rwandan genocide-like retaliation, and from the comments under my videos, I see it's the youth in particular whom are becoming more and more radical. I know this kind of radicalism has nothing to do with MGTOW's philosophy, and I highly doubt you're doing real MGTOW or any man-supporting movement any good. What I do know is that you're playing directly into the hands of these women, who love to portray the entire manosphere as misogynist extremists. I think there's a possibility this matriarchal empire will be built by chained hands of castrated males whose life depends on whether he's viable for this matriarchy. Men empowered women and then gave them total governing power to either join or walk away, assuming society will collapse without them, though not foreseeing they themselves will be enslaved to build the female society. Men will even help legislating the very laws which enables women to do it, while giving up on society or mentally dwindling into a black pill state of accepting human nature, but also bitterness and depression. And this is exactly how they want you to be, bitterly accepting their reality, a livestock more easy to control. In Matrix analogy, this illusion of sovereignty and not foreseeing the loss of sovereignty could be considered to the blue pill mentality. When all this time, you were thinking that the blue pillars were the people who don't have a clue that this is actually happening. In this sense, you might have swallowed the black pill which was offered to you by the feminist phonocentric agenda.
You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
What?
When Morpheus offered Neo the blue and red pill, taking the red pill was actually an empowering action. I don't recall Neo's reaction being, "I now sit back and do nothing." Of course, the red and blue pill are just analogies taken from the Matrix movie. But this is the real Matrix. There's only one solution that I support, and that's the non-violent process of restoring our laws. This compromises two key propositions. 1. Propositions for bills reversing or changing already implemented laws which are Duluth modeled, anti-male, pro-female, anti-life, and violating international human rights. 2. A proposition for a treaty or amendment in the international human rights law which halts the legislation of any new Duluth modeled anti-male, pro-female, and anti-life laws. This would be an International Human Rights Gender Equality Act, protecting the human rights by outlawing female gender bias laws and legislating laws in which men, women, and children are treated equally. The first step to take would be to set a Brighton model against the Duluth model, or call it whatever you want. Going over the international human rights law, the laws against domestic violence are clearly violating at least 8 out of the 12 articles, which basically is a crime against men, done by the state, as it is the duty of the states to respect, ensure, and fulfill these rights. This means implementing an amendment in human rights law or even humanitarian law, which stops any new
The look of love is in your eyes.
Adaptation, improvisation, but your weakness is not your technique.
Jesus Christ, he's fast. Take a look at his neurokinetics, they're way above normal.
What are you waiting for? You're faster than this. Don't think you are. Know you are.
Come on, stop trying to hit me and hit me.
This means implementing an amendment in human rights law or even humanitarian law, which stops any new proposition for laws taking away men's rights from being legislated. If the human rights of a child, regardless of gender or age, are violated, the same applies, which means there will never be any rights to be given to the mother, empowering her to legally terminate the life of her child. A petition, census and poll website would be needed. A clear definition of such a Brighton Bill and Brighton Fourth Protocol Amendment should be up there, as well as the opportunity to vote on these two propositions. These would be hypothetical referendums, polls and votes, but votes nonetheless. And it has to be an independent website, as petitions.org would probably ban it. Such a website should also be used to gather information about all the anti-male laws of all countries which need to be changed. It won't be enough to actually legislate these acts, but what it will do is get mainstream media coverage. Getting mainstream coverage, they will initially proclaim this online referendum as alt-right or whatever they're inclined to call it. However, this claim won't hold up because it will be undeniably clear this is a vote for unbiased and true gender equality, which will result in a mainstream media debate about redefining gender equality. Once viral and over a million of votes for a so-called Brighton Bill, this could be presented to world leaders, key organizations, political parties and its leaders. This website should also assemble stories of men who fell victim of these anti-male gender bias laws. Bookmark the website avabrighton.org in case this YouTube channel will be deleted. The website is not online yet, I'm working on it. To be clear, I want a website where both men and women anonymously can share their personal story of what happened to them or their loved ones thanks to these gender-biased, man-hating laws. It will be some sort of a guestbook of stories which in the past have never been documented, as most men who fell victim of these laws usually remain silent or killed themselves. Secondly, I want a place where everyone around the world can sign a petition to get the laws changed for the good of men. This will happen later when we all together have created the perfect idea for new laws to protect men against these, for example, Duluth model-based laws. I want a place where everyone can submit their ideas, existing laws that need to be changed, so that we, as a collective, can create the proposition for new laws. Once we have created the perfect laws and know which laws need to be reversed, we can create the petition on the website to gather as much signatures as possible. This way, everyone can see the truth. They will hear stories they have never heard before, or to which they have turned a blind eye. All men who are victims of these man-hating laws will finally have a place to tell their story. And this way, we can show the world that there are hundreds of thousands of people, men and women, who demand a change in laws. Once the website is online, I will let you know via my YouTube channel. But if my YouTube channel did not survive the YouTube purge, please know that the website and future videos of mine will be accessible on avabrighton.org. New ideas will be added to the website later, but this is the first idea of what my website will look like and what it is for. This is the only way to unite. And it's the only uniting I meant when I said that both men and women should unite. I didn't mean unite on the streets while these anti-male laws are still active. I meant online, on a website, all stories together, all signatures for the same demand in change of laws. This is uniting and demanding a change. While we don't know where this will be going, at least it's a start. And I hope you will join me and urge your friends to join as well. Because we can carry on making videos, debating and commenting, consoling and feeling frustrated, getting banned, blocked and cornered forever. But in the meantime, time is running out. Women will start governing countries and men will respond. And if we want to avoid a war between genders, the war on men and the war on our newborn children, We know very well we need to step in right now and reverse these laws. Only if you see there's no turning back, if you see that they will have you cornered, and you see your only option is to lose your human rights, your possessions and your children, I would recommend you prevent your face from getting hit by a puck. Of course, there's a flip side to this matriarchal coin. These women think they are creating a matriarchy, but in fact it's a totalitarian dystopia they built, and it won't be their world to govern, which makes it a cause worth fighting for. Men should become men again. Women should become normal again. It's the only way to fight against the upcoming dark times for men. Don't just educate men how to deal with a completely disrupted generation of females. Educate the women too. My own videos prove that I had no idea of the truth of the first and second wave of feminism. I had no idea both women and men didn't have the right to vote until the early 1900s. I had no idea the number of male victims of gender bias laws until I was introduced to it. And people need to know, because once they know, a lot of this is going to change. And to conclude my video with some optimism, the social justice warrior millennial feminist fatigue is already causing a shift. I have seen the radical women I discussed in my videos running amok in the streets of London after they lost the UK election, while radical left is losing face with their impeachment, which to me resembles a woman accusing a man by abusing a law. Forced legislation of new laws which protects men, women and their children. This is getting real sovereignty against an agenda which is about to take it all away from us. To see the system for what it really is, if you want to use these analogies, is to swallow the red pill. To discover the brutal truths of war, which is created between men and women. And this agenda, of course, being the real Matrix. Because we all have seen the movie, and we all know how it's going to end.
What?